Hello, crypto community. My name is Benny, and today I will show you how to send and receive cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin on the Binance Exchange. The Binance Exchange is one of the world's largest crypto exchanges, and this tutorial is dedicated to beginners. So if you are new to Binance, then just follow along. We will start from the very beginning. Make sure that the Binance website is maximized so that you can see all the navigation points, and we will start with accessing your wallet. You will find the wallet option in the top navigation bar, and there you will see that it has submenus, and the one that we are interested in is the one called Fiat and Spot. It also has the subtitle Deposit and Withdraw. Deposit means receiving crypto assets, and withdraw means sending crypto assets somewhere else. Let's jump into it. You may ask why it is called fiat and spot, so let me explain that. Fiat relates to real money, like euros or US dollars. So if you deposit euros or US dollars on Binance, then those will be also listed here on this page. And spot relates to crypto assets that you own. So for example, I own Ethereum and I own Litecoin. So I'm on spot with these, and that's why they show up here. In total, there are more than 1,000 coins available on Binance. If I scroll down that list, you can see that there are many, and also like a lot of pages. So over 1,000 coins, which makes it not always easy to find the coin that you are looking for. That's why I recommend you to really get to know to these short versions here, like LTC, or ETH, these are the abbreviations, and make really use of them because you can search for a coin with these. And I'm now interested in ETH, so that's how it will filter all the ETH ones. And I have Ethereum then on top, and it makes it way more easier for me to find the ones that I'm looking for. Now that you know how to find your coin, let's check how to deposit more of this coin to your wallet. And for this, you need to know what is your wallet address. And a wallet is like a real wallet. So it's something where you can store something. And of course, in a digital wallet, you store digital assets. And you will find your wallet address when clicking on deposit. There you see now different deposit networks. They are really important. I will tell you in a minute why. But the most important here on this page is your wallet address, which is listed here. You can copy it by clicking this button, and then you have it in your clipboard and you can send it to someone to send you cryptocurrencies. But as mentioned, very important is the deposit network, because this must match. If someone sends you cryptocurrencies with a deposit network that is not compatible with your wallet, then those cryptocurrencies will be lost, so they will be lost in void. No one will refund them. They are then just gone. And it's really, really important to make sure that the sender and receiver use the same deposit network and that it's also compatible. So to recap, first select the coin here, in this example, ETH. Then select the deposit network. You can see the arrival time when I send now cryptocurrencies using the ERC20 network. It will take around 20 minutes to arrive. And if someone sends us ETH over the ERC20 network, then of course it also takes around 3 minutes to arrive on our end. You can also have different networks to transfer coins. And as mentioned, the speed here is important. So different networks have different delivery speeds, but they also have different transaction fees, because for every transaction, which is for example depositing or withdrawing assets, you pay some fee, and this fee can vary on the network. And when switching here the network, also verify that the wallet address still is the correct one. So go to, for example, ERC20, copy this wallet address, give it to someone, and then the other party knows how to send you cryptocurrencies. How does sending work? So we learned how to receive cryptocurrencies. So we learned how to receive Ethereum. How can we send Ethereum? I will showcase that. And for my demo, I will use my own wallet address, so I copy it here. I remember that I want to use the ERC20 network, and I go back to Fiat and Spot. Then I go to Ethereum because I want to send Ethereum, and now I select withdraw. Now we get a very nice tutorial from Binance. They suggest us to select the coin first, which is ETH. Then we need to put the address that we want to send Ethereum to, and next we need to select a network. Afterwards, of course, we need to enter the amount, and then we will also see a preview of the transaction fee that will be deducted, and we can then submit our transaction to be processed. Good. Let's click on done here. And then I will enter my Ethereum address. I copied it into the clipboard, so I can just paste it here. This is my Ethereum address. And I can select the transfer network. And now we see the big differences. Like the Binance chain charges us 24 cents for the transaction, but the Ethereum network charges us $14. So there's a huge difference from 24 cents to $14. We can also use BSC when the other party uses BSC, and then it's 19 cents. So big differences, and you need to make sure that, of course, the one that you send the money to also has this network available, because there are different exchanges like Kraken, Coinbase Pro, Bitpanda, and others, and they might use other transfer networks. But this will be known to the one that receives money. He or she can tell you which network should be used. Let's play it through using the Binance Smart Chain. The Binance Smart Chain is good when you want to send cryptocurrencies to another Binance account. So let's say your friend also uses Binance, then the Binance Smart Chain might be also available. So you can use your account with the Binance Smart Chain to send then Ethereum to the other Binance account. And this way it will be very fast and also much cheaper than using the Ethereum network. Next, go into the amount field and here select how much Ethereum you want to send. There might be a minimum amount that you need to send. Let's try something out. I want to send 0.001. And if I do that, then the exchange is fine with that, and I see that also a transaction fee will be deducted. So if I send 0.001, then the other party won't get 0.001, but 0.00089, because this fee here is deducted. So how can I make sure that the other party gets this amount? I need to add the transaction fee, of course. So the transaction fee we've seen here is like 11 ETH with four zeros here in front. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 11. If I enter this amount, then the other party will get 0.001 as I wanted to have it in the beginning. Now I can click submit, and then of course I need to confirm the transaction using two-factor authentication. There's one more thing that I want to show you. I want to highlight that wallet addresses are dependent on the coin. So if I go back to Fiat and Spot, and now we'll select Litecoin, then I can see that when I go to deposit, that I have a different wallet address. So remember that different coins, different wallet addresses. So always check that deposit network and wallet address are really the ones that are shown here to you on Binance. And also, like, different coins and different networks always have different transaction fees. So for example, if I go to withdraw with Litecoin, then I get the same introduction here from Binance. And let's pick Litecoin here. Let's use LTC as the network. And we see that here, for example, the fee is by default like 19 cents with the LTC network, and other networks have different prices. Great. Now you learned how to receive crypto assets. You also learned how to send crypto assets. And if you want to learn more about Binance, for example, how to trade currencies and how to use technical analysis, then please let me know, because I will make new videos based on your feedback. And also, if you want to support my channel, there's a referral link in the description of that video, so you can use it to sign up yourself, and then you will get a small bonus from Binance, and I will also get something for my work here. Thank you very much. Have a great day.